All right, we are on the play for round three. This is definitely the worst hand we've seen so far. Still think it's a keep, though. Like I said, the deck does not mulligan great. We have two creatures and a spell. It's pretty hard to throw it back if it's got a reasonable curve. This is definitely the kind of hand, though, where if you draw a couple lands, you're in pretty bad shape. All right, that's not great. Getcha. Fortunately, this matchup is really, really good. So he gets a swamp. Mostly just because they don't have a lot of ways to interact that are meaningful at all. So you kind of just goldfish them while they try to goldfish you, but your deck is significantly better under those circumstances than theirs. So unfortunately, we have nothing, so we're just going to pump thrice. Opponent plays the swamp we knew about. We'll take one. It's also nice that Golgari, whatever the 2/1 that grows, Lotlith Troll, can't be regenerated through Rapid Hybridization, because Rapid Hybridization does not allow for regeneration. So Herald of Torment, yeah, shuts us off pretty nicely here, and another land is just brutal. I guess we could offer the trade here, but I don't think that's a good line for us. I think how we're gonna win this game is by overloading Cyclonic Rift, because we have enough lands to do it, and then like hitting back for a bunch. So we'll leave Herald of Torment in play for now, dealing a damage a turn. Alright, some salvaging. No land, if that's what he was looking for, so that might be good for us, might be bad. Let's see what he picks. I like to leave the cards that they pick, like, up in this revealed window so that I can just keep track of what's in their hand. Normally, in a paper tournament, I'd write them down, but on Magic Online, you don't have to do that. So he took the Night Howler. That's interesting. I've never seen this card in this deck before. I wonder if he's actually playing red or just wanted more scry lands. All right, he scryed to the top. So once again, we've got nothing. Your turn. Hopefully he's like scared of dissolve or something. I don't know. I feel like we don't have any action, so there's not a lot we could be doing differently. Like, we could have tried to trade this Frostwyrm Weird for Herald, but I don't actually think that's even good. I think we'd rather just let the Herald of Torment hang out. I guess I'll pull up his graveyard too, because we will need to be keeping track of what's in there. We got one, two, three, four creatures so far. All right. And there's a Night Howler. And there's a Nemesis of Mortals. So this is some pressure. Hey, that's a spell. That's nice. So we just have to make sure we don't die next turn, and then the overload on Cyclonic Rift should actually be pretty huge. So this thing costs him. There's four creatures in his graveyard. So it costs 5 mana to make it into a 10/10. So I think we'll just not block. If he makes it into a 10/10, we just bounce it, and then we can kill him, right? Not right. Not exactly right. But we can almost kill him. Still not blocking, I think. Especially now that he's just attacking with the two guys. Yeah, we'll just take our Take our 9 damage. That guy's main deck. Didn't think that guy was normally main deck, but I guess he is today. Alright, your turn. Hopefully we don't die this turn. By which I mean, we're almost certainly going to lose this game at this point. Just took us too long to find a relevant spell, unfortunately. And yeah, he's just gonna be able to recast Nemesis and Night Howler. Or just the Shadowborn Demon is pretty strong. So we could chump them both and chump both of these guys, or chump here and chump here. I think I actually like that. We're going to cast Cyclonic Rift anyway, so if I do this, if I make these blocks, we might induce him to monstrous this guy and win the game on the spot. He's having none of that, so we'll just do what we were going to do. Well, I'd still keep this hand that we kept. I feel like if we'd drawn a spell, we'd have been favored, so... Like, this game is ending up being kind of close, despite the fact that we didn't draw a spell until turn 6 or so. I imagine the demon's going to come down and finish off the Frostburn Weird. Nope, he's going with the Nemesis plus Night Howler plan, it looks like. Which is certainly respectable. So now if we draw Tidebinder Mage, we might be in okay shape. It's not really a Tidebinder Mage. So we'll go ahead and do that. And unfortunately we only get to attack for one. We do have a flyer, so we can block if he bestows Night Howler, or bestows a Herald of Torment onto something. We can block that. Looks like he is not doing that. He's just going to attack. And we only have to block one of his guys here. I think we want to block with Mutavault, because it's less important than Frostburn Weird. Doesn't add to our devotion or anything. That's definitely one of the ways we can win here, is to find a Master of Waves. And for him to not have another Shadowborn Demon. Island, on the other hand, not the best. So he doesn't even have to sack a guy, right? Because he has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, he does have to sacrifice a guy. That's kind of convenient. I guess we'll just pass. See what he sacrifices. Definitely don't think we're going to be able to win this game. We're going to have to chump two guys this turn if he bestows Herald of Torment onto something. I mean, we're going to have to chump. Yeah, if he bestows Herald here, we have to chump both. I guess what we want to do is try and make sure that if we draw Master of Waves, we can still be in a position to win this game. Which I think just means blocking with Mutavault. If he has a land, he can actually just kill us with this guy, right? But I guess he doesn't have a land. Now he has a land. Yeah, so I'm assuming he's gonna just regrow Jared and then next turn kill us with it. we draw Thassa, I still don't think we can kill him. This would be a 2. You got Thassa, unblockable. Yeah. Not gonna cut it. Alright, so there's a Night Howler and probably a Lotlith Troll. Nope, a Commune. Which puts a Deathrite Shaman in his hand. Alright, well, you're way late to the party, Tidebinder. I think we're done here. He can bestow here to have 3 lethal-sized creatures, so we'd have to leave our whole team back. I guess we can Tidebinder one, so we'd have to leave most of our team back, but we're just having to chump away too much of our board. So that was unfortunate. For sideboarding, I like Rift, Rapid, don't like Domestication. It's basically very similar to the Monsters matchup, except I actually like Dissolve, because they're not that fast, and Shadowborn Demon is almost their only card that actually does anything. So I like to board out Nykthos, and I don't really think that the Bidence or the Judge's Familiars are great. I think we should leave Nykthos in, I meant. Just because they don't do much to kill most of your permanents. They can kill a few. Usually they just are trying to target the important ones like Master. So you get a lot of mana off Nykthos. But I think we're going to board out 2 Bidence and a Familiar. I would like leaving in a Bident, but the thing is, when you're boarding out Familiar, Bident becomes a lot worse, so I'd rather board all of them out. All right, here we go.